Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. The three Expedition 29 crew members on board the International Space Station have been joined in space, though not yet at the space station, by three additional Expedition 29 crew members. NASA astronaut Dan Burbank and Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Antonoly Ivanishin launched in their Soyuz TMA-22 from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan at 10:14 p.m. Central Time on Sunday. They're currently orbiting the Earth above the Atlantic Ocean, east of South America, and trailing behind the International Space Station, which is 234 miles above Indonesia at the moment. Two vehicles are scheduled to meet up at 11:33 p.m. Central Time tomorrow, Tuesday, when the Soyuz will be docking to the station's Russian Poisk module. NASA TV coverage of that event will begin at 11 p.m. Central, and the docking itself will be followed by a post-docking news conference from Russia. Then, at 1:30 a.m. on Wednesday, the Expedition 29 crew, currently at the station, U.S. Commander Mike Fossum, Russian flight engineer Sergei Volkov, and Japanese flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa, will be opening the space station hatches and welcoming their new crewmates aboard. Fossum, Volkov, and Furukawa spent part of their day, which began at midnight Central Time, preparing for their colleagues' arrival, but they've also spent part of their day preparing for their departure. They launched to the space station in their own Soyuz vehicle on June 7th and docked to the space station on June 9th, which means that they're wrapping up now their 160th day in space and their 158th day at the space station. That in turn means that they've almost reached the end of their stay. They're scheduled to undock from the space station a week from today on November 21st and return to Earth for landing in Kazakhstan. Despite all of those comings and goings and the preparation associated with them, the crew currently on board the space station has also managed to squeeze in a good bit of scientific work. Fossum worked today with the space drums, or space dynamically responding ultrasonic matrix system experiment, which aims to provide a suite of hardware capable of facilitating containerless advanced material science. He also performed an ultrasound on his leg as part of the SPRINT experiment, which evaluates the use of high-intensity, low-volume exercise training to minimize muscle, bone, and cardiovascular function loss during long stays in space. And he worked with the BCAT-6 experiment, or Binary Colloidal Alloy Test 6, which uses microscopic particles, or colloids, as models for studying the fundamental physics of a theoretically predicted, but until now unseen, liquid crystal phase. So, another busy day in space today with a full schedule on the agenda for tomorrow. This is Mission Control Houston.